Hello, everybody, and welcome back to episode 39 of the Baldur's Gate Trilogy Let's Play featuring Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition. We've come a long way on this one. So after resting up after that last battle with Grael, or whatever his name was, I got an item known simply as the Compass Wardstone, which will definitely be necessary to complete this dungeon and discover more of the secrets. Thought I'd take one last quick gander to see if there's anything interesting here. It looks like there's some monsters to fight.
I meant to do that.
Oh, I hate it when they do that. And of course they paralyze my bard again. Go. I think I know why. It's because I probably ran out of darts and didn't, you know. Get back. You. Just you two. Guys, go back! You dummies. I just hate it when monsters are smart. Yeah, let's head for the back line. Wouldn't even be that bad if my main character weren't there, but whoops. And I'm not out of darts. I've actually got quite a few left. It's, yeah, 108 or whatever. It's just, unfortunately, darts are just such short range. It really sucks. I need to get back to shooting bows and arrows before too long. Yeah, well, no big deal. Okay, so let's go ahead and actually, you know what? No, we're not rest yet.
It shall be, fine. Even bloodier than you hoped.
We'll just, you know, take on more. You know what? You know what? Fuck this. Nice. I'm getting sick of not using this. Let's turn you undead.
Nanatha.
Yeah.
You're not the tank.
Sure.
There we go. That's better. Probably should have done that a long time ago.
What do you want? Your worthless lives
end here. Of course, they still attack me regardless, but, you know, they probably do it when they're cornered. There we go. 1,000 experience a pop. Not too bad as far as consistency goes.
Try to keep up.
Let's see what else is around here. But yeah, I found some really handy items. I found a wand of monster summoning. I found a potion of fire giant strength. Yes, please. And I even found freedom of movement potions, which will be very handy dandy, especially after we leave the after we leave this place. And there's a lot of gold in here too. That one had like 900 something. I found one with over 1,000 gold in it. It's like, geez, how much more money do I need? Go ahead and give it to me anyway. Okay, there's a couple more secret passages here. That one actually leads out of the cave, which is, oh my god. And acid is annoying to deal with. I will just say that right now. Okay, everybody stop moving. Turn the undead! Right. It won't work on the carrion crawlers, though, so. No, I'm sorry. Crypt crawlers.
Here we go.
So sorry I got that one wrong. There we go. Hey, there we go. Jesus Christ. I do not use my abilities enough. Let's just attack things, because, you know, apparently everybody's a barbarian and I didn't realize it.
For sure!
Okay. Yeah, because I think they do fight back if they're cornered, which kind of sucks. It's like, why even bother sending everyone forward then? Just let the ranged characters take it while they just stay, you know. But it's not a big deal. I mean, I wouldn't do it if I didn't think I could handle it. Let's see what's in here. Oil of speed, blah, 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 blah. Okay. That's fine, you can keep it. Actually, you know what? Here. Oils of speed don't affect him because of his freedom of movement status. Which sucks. Oh well, no big deal. And I think that's actually it for this place, believe it or not. So, yeah. Okay, go ahead and turn on trap detection mode. See if it even works this time. Honestly, the acid damage isn't that bad. It's like one hit per pop. And funny thing about it is it only seems to hit one character at a time. It's like it's randomly determined. I don't know if there was some there's some limitation in the engine that said only one person could get hit at a time. But honestly, I'm not complaining. I mean, if all six people got hit at a time, that would suck. So, yep, there you go. The big pretty chest always has the big pretty traps. And I'm guessing it's locked, too. Ta-da! Yeah, when you actually decide to be smart for once. What's this? The Infernal Bone Shield, a necromancy spell. And this is actually, I think, a cleric one. Okay, so the spell conjures forth a barrier of floating fell skeleton and demon bones that spin rapidly around the caster. Anyone entering the path of the bones takes 1d6 crushing damage and 1d6 fire damage per round. Oh my god, yes! That sounds pretty good. I saw another. I think she has another spell that's similar to that, only it's not quite as good. What is it called? It's like, Circle of Bones. Here we go. Basically, it does the same thing, except it's 1d6 crushing and 1d6 slashing, and the caster cannot move. Yeah, that's bad. That's like the Diablo Necromancer, except it sucks. So, let's see here. Yeah, I'll give it to you. Or, no. Well, actually, you know what? No, let's give this to you. Because, I mean, Edwin, you would never have him up front close. Up close person with the enemy. The Bard, I'd be okay with if I absolutely had to. And even then, you know, that's a big-ass if. But in the meantime, let's take a look at what we have. The Staff of Striking +3. One of the few +3 weapons in the game. It's actually really useful. Well, let's see. Unfortunately, it's only +3 for 20 hits, and then after that becomes a regular staff, so not all that useful. But there is another +3 staff that we can buy in Ulgoth Spirit that doesn't have such a limitation. And then this is the Burning Earth +1. I don't know if this is a flame. Yeah. +1, +2 versus creatures, +3 versus cold using creature, +4 versus undead. Okay, so yeah, we'll definitely hang on to this one too. And funny little thing. I actually noticed all brewing, which is actually meant to be more of an anti-shapeshifter weapon because it gives you immunity to poison and sex invisibility once per day. It actually does more damage overall than this baby, which I was kind of blown away by, but I thought, you know what? I'm not going to worry about it. I'm not going to argue with it.
I will listen.
Doesn't have as good an enhancement, which kind of sucks, but
try to keep up.
Okay, so there's definitely a trap or two in here. Let's see here. Oh yeah, there's definitely a trap or two in here. I remember this hallway. Okay, it doesn't look like we're in range of it.
I cannot fall.
Oh, right. Oh, it's that kind of trap. I'm gonna reload. I hate this place. Yeah, it's one of those crushing water. I swear to God, isn't there something that we can disable to keep from triggering?
And be gone. It shall be.
Or am I just? Oh, okay. Well, there it is. Okay. Well, that's hilarious. We just stood there and waited for damn near 6 seconds, and nope. They're just. Yeah. I don't. Again, this game confuses me. The trap finding thing is just utter balls. Okay. It's terrible. Yeah, I'm not finding anything here, so I think we're safe to go this way. I don't know. Are we or aren't we?
Life is adventure.
Be direct. Try to keep up.
See, we just have to take it really slow. There's nothing I can do about that. Okay, I think we're safe. I'm genuinely scared to move in this place. Oh, I hate it.
Yes.
I hate it so much.
Speak and be gone.
What is your bidding?
I will listen for now.
Yeah, whatever. Okay. Okay, so there's, let's see here. I think this is as far as we can go. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, so that's as far as we can go that way. Okay.
Life is adventure.
I think we're safe to go down here. See?
You hoped.
Jeez, me Christmas. Of all the douchebag DMs I could pick, I just had to pick the CPU. The cold and... God damn it! Cold and unfeeling, heartless bastard. Oh, man. But yeah, that's why I turned off the bouncy feature for the lightning bolt. Because otherwise we would all be screwed. And that's not fun. Okay, so let's... Okay. Okay, here. This, I believe, is where we use the compass ward stone. Here we go! And looky here! A throne!
Life is keep the trap. Beat
erect.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah?
Doesn't look like there's anything here, so... Okay, oh my god, look at all this money! 13,000- what am I gonna do with all this? Oh my god, that's hilarious. And look, I get even more money. This is hilarious. I freaking love it. It's awesome. I mean, I got so many gems, I can't carry them all, so... Oh my god. I don't know why I'm doing this, but screw it. I'm an adventurer in a D&D game. I'm obligated to pick up everything that's shiny. Oh my gosh. So good, so good. Star sapphires, diamonds, just the whole lot of it. Really good stuff. Oh man, if only money were that easy to come by in real life. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at this. Oh, it's locked. Quite safe, just to be safe. Okay, we haven't seen any traps, so I think we're safe. Gosh. Just 72 gold. Okay, this is where things get a little interesting. Click the throne. And we are in the first of three rooms that are... excuse me. We are in the first of three rooms that are essentially riddles. Okay, so, basically, like I said, there's three riddle rooms, and these basically work by the statues telling you a story, and then you have to answer a question about it. So you definitely want to pay attention to what you see and hear, and let's see. So the stone golem is the one, let's see, in the southeast. West corner, I believe, is one that always asks you the questions. And then the other three are basically the tale tellers. So let's start with this one.
I could do that.
We came to kill, but not without reasons. We were here before, as were the tentacles. Their underground was near, and a tower intruded on their expansions as well. The bait was too great to pass. The dwarves did not hide their wealth. Did not stop the rumors of waist-deep gold. The invaders came and still come, but not without invite. We came to kill, but not without reasons. Yeah, I'm sure money really justifies your cost. Anyway. But yeah, tentacles. It turns out it wasn't just doppelgangers, but actually mind flayers as well. Oh, wait. Oh, dang it. I will not choose now. Oh, hell. I hate that. Okay, I picked the wrong one. It's actually the north east one. Again, I haven't played in a while. There was no warning, but it would not be. There was no warning, but it would not have helped. There was no need to prepare for the hard times because hard times would never come. So we were assured, and so we believed. The great troll killer was our provider, and he would protect us. We put down our swords to the life he always wanted. We loved his family. Suspicions were for outsiders. Guards' weapons were for wartime. There was no warning, but it would not have helped. And that's the dwarven one. And then here is another, I believe, dwarven one. We crafted as we were told. We built this place to prevent all from entering. We trapped every inch of every step and made sure that to enter meant death. We have killed many over time, though it is not our will. It is all to protect against a repeat of the past, though the challenges ensure it will repeat. A mountain is to climb, a river to cross. Because it is there, they will come. We crafted as we were told. Okay, so now he's going to ask us a question about what we've read. This is the end of things. Here I stood and struck them down as they came. my family and my clan with their false faces. They dropped all pretenses and drew their weapons against me. I fought them to the last, killing the shape-changers that had taken their forms. I cursed them for destroying the dream, but they were not the real evil. The real evil could not save my people before this deception. The real evil hid from life in the face of this tragedy. The real evil deserves blame. This is the end of things. Answer where the blame has fallen. The blame begins with the invaders, but they attacked with supposed good reason. It could be on your people, but they were in a shelter of your confidence. The craftsmen only did their job as directed. In your eyes, you're the one to blame for all this happened. This is the one. You have understood. You may yet survive, but I cannot. If you get the question wrong, you'll get damaged by something, and then you'll have to try again. So, you know, if nothing else, it's just a trial and error quiz. Okay, now we talk to this guy again.
Hey. All right.
You have found the room that gives direction, but are not done yet. The way is not yet clear. Understand the paths that lead away, and you will return.
Be direct.
Now that we've done what I feel to be the worst part of the dungeon, we'll move on to the next one, which I think is a lot better just because of the fact that you can get some really, really, really nice gear up here. As always, though, keep your eyes out for traps. I freaking hate this place. I really do. Let's see. Oh, and here. Check this out. This is another ghost. This is Islan. This is Durlag's wife.
What's up? Uh-huh.
You have come far and seen much, but not all would stay, leaving what I offer. Irritate the spirit no more. Leave this place and let the madness that keeps the world above is yours. Definitely dead and will not let it go. Thanks, it's the same, but I'll stay. But yeah, that's another quick way out if you want to do it. I'm purposely not going to do that because I'm kind of worried that
fun.
I might not be able to get out again. I don't even know if I can open this door. Yeah, I didn't think so. Okay, then.
Be direct. Try to keep up.
Let's see here. Okay. Now, this room is a little dangerous.
Life is adventure.
Speak and be try to keep up.
See this barrier right here? You ain't gonna cross it right now. You need an item or something to get across, otherwise you're in trouble. And I think the next question to be asked is there. Dum dum diddy dee. Okay. Okay, this I believe, let's see, there's another.
Yes.
I think there's another trap nearby, but I can't remember. Oh, yes, this is, okay. I am too far away to interact with the device. This machine seems to be the power source for something in a room to the north. A small inscription above, please not read. Enter bone wardstone here in order to see what room traps. So likely they had some really, really serious stuff here that they decided could only be utilized by those who had the right items. Okay, so, ding dong, in we go. Okay, so, stop. Okay. Hey, we found a trap. It's so much fun waiting 6 seconds to find a trap. Okay.
Speak and be gone.
Speaking of which. Okay, you know what, I can use these now. So, I actually switched away from the arrows of biting at some point because undead do not take extra damage from there. Biting effect, so... Okay. Oh, and yeah, there's edder caps in here. And there are spiders in here. You wanna guess what else is in here? Fucking caps. Please do not die. Oh, crap! No. I'm not doing this again. Is that polymorph? Oh, fuck. I have a polymorph self spell. I should probably use that.
Speak and be gone.
You are fine.
This will not be a quarter death.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Fuck that noise. And also, why are you not fighting? Please do that. There you go.
What do you want?
This will not be a quick death.
Oh, man. I'm like on pins and needles right now. Yes. Okay. Got rid of those.
Yes.
Oh, just wait, kids. It gets worse from here.
Great peril yields great beauty.
I hate this place. I hate it what so much. And yet I love it, too. That's what I love the most about Durlax Tower. It's pretty much, even amidst this ball spawn saga that we're going through, it's pretty much its own self-contained dungeon. I mean, you could have this in, like, any game, and it would work perfectly, because it's got its own story and everything. And it's pretty interesting how they wrote it, too. You know, it's essentially about a dwarf that just wanted to live a peaceful life after his days of, troll killing and such. Oh, for crying out loud. After his days of troll killing finally ended, and...
Take him down!
And yet, even when he supposedly finally got the perfect home built, just didn't seem to work. Also, is this... Yes, it is. It's an oh, for crying out loud. An astro-faced spider. It doesn't really do much else other than be perma-hasted like a sword spider. Because, you know, that's fun to deal with. Okay. Crying out loud. God
hey.
Damn it. Leave me alone!
Again, you disturb me.
Here we go.
Here, let's just remove the threat before it even gets to me. There you go. There you go. That is how it's done. Alright. Man, I'm pretty damn certain there are spider traps in here. I mean, I swear I see a corpse or two. Nah, not again.
Yes. Great peril yields great beauty.
Be direct.
Go. Nice. Ah, regular face spider. Good. Astral ones are considerably harder to hit.
What is your bidding?
All right. Let's see what else is in here.
Wherever fate takes me.
I mean, you cannot fool me. There are traps in here for sure. Let's kind of stay around to the outside, though, just to be safe. I think the outside is safe. Okay, here. No, let's see. That's good.
Life is great peril yields great beauty.
All right.
I will listen. Try to keep
seems
up.
Oh, for yes. Damn it! They just pop out of nowhere. I swear to... Oh.
What's up?
Wait, of course they do. They're astral spiders. They're popping out of the astral plane. Yeah, dummy. Please leave my ranged characters alone. Especially the wizard. He tends to be, you know, die easy. Speaking of which, I need to drink a potion. Oh, crap. Damn it! Keep forgetting to give him potions. Screw it. Just drink this one. Eat it. Oh, we got him. Okay, good. Cool. Alrighty, here we go. I don't know, everything seems to be safe, but I'll not trust it.
It shall be even bloodier than you hoped.
What's this? Let's see, the wood structure lies over a deep pit. You cannot tell the exact depth of the pit, but when you toss a pebble in a small, you don't seem to hear the stone hit the bottom. That would be bad. Okay. Oh, here. Here's something. Here's a golem, and he's gonna ask you questions too, because by golly, riddles just never get old. Okay. Alright. And be careful, if you muck this up, you can get hurt, so.
Alright.
Questions have I for you. None but kin of clan of might may pass. State your knowledge of the history. Answer true, and the way is clear. Answer false, and fear all the sorrow. There's no second chance, neither for true nor false. You must answer now. Let's do it. If you count Durlag, son of Bolthur Thunderax, as your kin, you will know well the family that built this place, the mother of the sons, the matron of the clan. What is her name? Her name is Islan. Your answer satisfies. Another question remains. Durlag, builder of the home, founder of the clan, had a name not for his father, but for his own deeds. The tower was built with the fortunes of hordes, but the last name of Durlag came from the fortunes of battle. With axe and fire, he cleansed the land of beasts he loved to fight when axe alone would not suffice. I ask the second name of Durlag. Strollkiller. Your answer satisfies. A question remains. The father of this place formed the clan that fell in times of treachery. False faces claimed the future, and clanless became Durlag. This he shared with his own father, a wanderer that lived by the strength of his weapon. The second name of Bolthur is what I ask you. He literally just said it a moment ago. Jesus fucking Christ. Here's the key to what you need. Here's the secret for what comes to bones walk where flesh cannot. The ward will walk the bones. And we get another riddle. Okay. Let's see here. Alrighty. Let's do this in clockwise order this time. I don't know why I feel like doing that.
Sure.
We were hired after the battles were done. Durlag called upon us to make his visions true. We did our best, but his visions grew darker, and soon we could not see. We waded through his fallen, and we waded through his gold. Near the end, we feared for our lives, though not as much as he did. I was never truly sure whether he wished to keep the intruders out or himself in. Both, I'll wager. We were hired after the battles were done, and we did our best. This is not my face. The invaders came and took my true face, burying it with my body and my comrades. I was among the last, but not the very last, and I saw the horror to come. My child rose against me, though it was no longer my child. It wore her face, but I knew her to be dead. The doppelgangers came from within, and we could not fight ourselves. Better to die than to kill ourselves. What would be left of a man that has had to kill his family and himself? I was among the last, but not the very last. It began with us and the masters. The tentacled ones directed, and we assaulted quietly with the cover of night. We took off with the weaker first, hiding amongst the children. None saw the arrival, none noticed the insurgent, and none survived the final rise. When Durlag realized deception, it was too late. His own family saw his life, and he slaughtered their false faces. It began with us from the west. Okay. With me, it ended. Speak now of the troubles to show that you have learned. From when did my pain come? Where did my pain stab home? Where did my pain take root? Where does my pain reside? Speak, and you shall can. And you shall understand. Let's see, from the west it came, and then the south. We know it started with the west, so that's easy. Okay, yes, it's this one. Doesn't make sense that it came from the west again, since it already came from there. You have learned a little. You may let it survive.
Be direct.
And off we go.
What do you want?
You have found the room that gives direction, but are not done yet. The way is not yet clear. Understand the path to lead away, and you will return.
Speak and be gone.
Okay, so let's see. Now you got the ward stone, right? Or did he get the ward stone? Somebody got the ward stone. See here.
I will listen.
In any case, can use this to. Okay, we're not gonna worry about that. Oh, for God's sakes. Ah, damn it. Okay, hang on.
This will not be a-
Helmed Horror. Just great. Technically the easiest to kill the horrors. What are you doing? But all the same, still pretty dangerous. There we go. I like that little pattern it does when it dies. It has a winged helmet. That's pretty. Okay, now we have to go to wherever the hell that thing was. No. Yep. Do not go that way. Just because it doesn't look like it's part of the barrier doesn't mean it's safe. Okay, hello everyone. I'm back once more. Well, that was a bit misleading. Turns out the statue doesn't actually give you the bone ward stone. But I think he does provide access to where you can get it. And it's actually up here next to Islan. So that was irritating. But whatever. We'll live.
Speak and be gone.
Yeah.
So turns out we do have to fight these guys now.
I will listen. Be direct.
If I remember correctly, I think they're immune to missile damage, so... Nice. Okay.
Even bloodier than you hoped.
And here's another one. Okay. And... There we go. Alright. Go us. Okay. As usual, check for traps.
I will listen.
And there it is.
Life is adventure or nothing. Wherever fate takes me.
Okay. Potions. And here it is. And some other weapons that are of use. Okay. So first off, we'll identify the Bone Ward Stone and then give it to you. Then we will identify the ammunition and give it to you. Identify this. And of course... give to you. Hooray. Okay. Alright. Nice. Okay. Next up. So now we finally have that thing. We can now push on to the next room and get some really, really fun toys. Can't wait to see them. Okay, so... this way, please. Pathfinder.
Girl, I don't think I've laid eyes on.
Let's see. When you enter the Bone Ward Stone, you feel the machine hum for a few moments and quiet down. You're sure that something has been turned off. And now we can go over here with impunity. Ta-da! Hooray! We're safe. Okay. I don't know if there are still any traps in here. My luck, there probably are. So we'll interact with that when we are ready to, but in the meantime. Let's see. Ah, there it is. Trap. Ha, I'm smart. I'm smart enough to remember to do this every now and then.
This place okay. Seems fun.
Oh, here we go. Oh my goodness. As if things didn't get exciting enough. Okay, so first off, we'll claim these, and then we'll give these to you. Your inventory space, like, you're running out. Not a big deal. Okay.
Luck, be a lady.
Now, this large shield. According to the guide, the shield of the stars that Durlak has right now is the best shield in the game. I beg to differ. This one is the best. Because it gives you armor class plus 3 against everything. The plus 1 bonus isn't quite as high as the Falling Stars, but still, I mean... I'll take one extra armor class against everything against that, so... Actually, what's your strength that you need? Really? Tense? You're kidding me. Oh, wow. Okay, you know what? I lied. We'll give this to you. No, it's too heavy! Okay, here. There we go. And then we'll just give it to you. Oh my god, negative 10! I love it! Oh, and of course I keep forgetting she has a source of fireballs of her own. We got this from somewhere else. I can't remember. But yeah. So that's that thing.
Yes.
Let's see here.
Great peril yields great beauty.
What? Dude, you didn't... Oh my god, are you serious? Hey, could you maybe stop taking damage, please? That'd be great. It's not even... Oh, okay, good. I think we got it. Didn't even clarify itself as poisoning. Is that a bug? I swear to god. I guess you just have to be in minimum range to find the traps, I guess. It's infuriating. But whatever. I mean, it kind of.
Where am I supposed
sense.
To put that exactly?
What? What do you have? Oh shit! Okay. Here, give it to him. Okay, and this is a Crotan Skullcrusher plus 2. Critical hand chance 5% with this weapon only. Oh, plus 5%. Okay. Okay. That's nice. It does an extra 1d6 on top of the double damage it deals. Let's see. What are you wielding? Great. She can't heal. Okay. 24 plus 3 plus 24. It actually does more damage, believe it or not. So, yeah. Screw it. We'll do it. Oh my gosh. She's running out of room. So, you know what? She can't use this wand anyway. We'll just give it to someone else. Okay. All right. 69%. Nice. For now. I think that's it. There is one more thing I want to check just to be safe. I don't know if I took a look in here or not.
Out of
the way, please. Okay, it's just Warhammer plus one. I know that much. And a barrel of nothing. All right, sweet. Now let's go here and click on that final riddle, and then we'll finally have what we need to get the hell out of this place. All right, let's go. Whoosh. Okay, clockwise zones.
Yep.
We entrenched this place against all that would come. We built retribution in the tripwires and vengeance in the fireballs. Okay, then. We worked the hatred into every nook and cranny just as he wished, but our actions were guided from elsewhere. The foundation was the fear that it could happen again, and this was to be prevented at all costs. This was the mortar that held him together. We entrenched this place against all that would come, friends and foe alike. Oh, boy. We followed Durlag. We were his people, his family. Durlag Trollkiller, son of Bolthor. Bolher. Is that an L or a T? No, that's an L. Oh, great. It's hard enough to pronounce as it is. Bolher Thunderaxe. The Clanless formed this place with the spoils of a lifetime of adventure. It was majestic in those times, and we took what we needed from the fortune around us. We grew strong and proud, and Durlag felt he finally had a home. We were the future, his family, and if we were lost, then so was he. That was the fear that hid. That was beneath. We followed Durlag. We were his people. Okay. I will listen. We were the fear made flesh. We came to the home that Durlag built. We hid in the people that he formed. With tentacles to guide, we poisoned the clan, and the nightmares of Durlag came true. Our master said they could taste his rage even in the air, but always there was a fear behind. We were the fear made flesh, but it was already here. Okay. That in mind, let's answer the riddle. My father roamed his eye and saw much of the world in his time. Well respected he was, but he had no home. At his end, he died in some faraway land with no dwarven kin by his side. I would not allow such to happen to me. I would not follow his steps that far. I would not be Durlag the Clanless. This was my fear. Trace the path of his fear and show me what you have learned. Okay. Yeah, that sounds about right. Because they talk about it already happened once, he wanted to prevent it again. So, this one. You know a little more of me, you may yet live. Whoosh! And here we are. And I forgot to explore this room, by the way. You will survive this place. You understand what built the hate, the fear. Now you must prevent it from becoming worse. A creature below, power beyond all, you must remove, or it shall make this place its own. Such a fortress, impenetrable if remade in its image. If there is evil to be fought, I will defeat it. There is always evil to be fought, within and without. Do as you will, the way is clear, follow me. Okay, so, we can... Hey. I'm not worried about following him right now. Let's see.
Yep.
Great,
What's up?
What is your bidding?
Great peril yields great beauty.
Okay, let me quick save real quick. Oh, that's another entrance to the... Yeah, we've already been there. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's back to... Okay, anyway. Alright. Let's go find the Durlagster. That was terrible. The Durlagster? Did I really just say that? Okay, stop. Because he moves incredibly slow. But he will be guiding us to the exit of the building where we will take on the Demon Knight next time in this Let's Play. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, take care of yourselves, and farewell.